नमस्कार माय डियर फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ मशीन डिजाइन। इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स यू हैव लर्न अबाउट द डिजाइन प्रोसीजर ऑफ द बेवल गियर। नाउ टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस सॉल्व द एग्जांपल्स एंड अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू डिजाइन द बेवल गियर। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद एग्जांपल नंबर वन। अ पेयर ऑफ बेवल गियर्स कनेक्ट टू शाफ्ट एट राइट एंगल्स and transmit 9 kilowatt. Determine the required module and gear diameters for the following specifications. Check the gear for dynamic and wear load. The different data: number of teeth on pinion TP is equal to 21, number of teeth on gear TG is equal to 60, material of the gear is gray cast iron and material of the pinion is semi steel. Then the Brinell hardness number BHN for pinion is 200 and for gear is equal to 160. Allowable static stress sigma OP is equal to 85 megapascal and allowable static stress for gear material sigma OG is equal to 55 megapascal. Speed of pinion NP is equal to 1200 rpm and speed of gear NG is equal to 420 rpm. Tooth profile phi is equal to 14.5 degree composite in both cases pinion as well as gear. Okay. Now both the shafts are at right angle each other, so therefore theta S is equal to 90 degree and power to be transmitted is equal to 9 kilowatt, so 9000 watt. Okay, now we have to find the module and diameter, and then we have to check this design for the dynamic as well as the wear load. So first of all, we have to find out the pitch angle of the pinion as well as gear. Okay, so both the shafts are right angle, so therefore theta S is equal to 90 degree. So let us equation for the pitch angle for pinion, theta P1, okay, so theta P1 is equal to tan inverse 1 by VR, where VR is the velocity ratio. Okay, so therefore VR is equal to, we know that the TG by TP, so therefore here we can say is equal to tan inverse TP by TG. Okay. 1 upon VR is equal to, so therefore TP by TG. Okay. Now put the value of TP and TG in this equation. So is equal to tan inverse. TP is equal to 21 and TG is equal to 60. Okay. So therefore the theta P1 is equal to 19.3 degree. Okay. Now similarly pitch angle for the gear, pitch angle for gear is theta P2. Let us find the theta P2 for gear. So is equal to theta S minus theta P1, because we know that the theta S shaft angle is equal to theta P1 plus theta P2. So therefore theta P2 is equal to theta S minus theta P1. So theta S is equal to 90 degree minus theta P1 is equal to 19.3 degree. Okay, so therefore theta P2 is equal to 70.7 degree. Now let us find the formative number of teeth for the pinion. So TEP, so value of TEP is equal to TP sec theta P1. Okay. TP sec theta P1. So TP is equal to 21 sec theta P1 is equal to 19.3 degree. So therefore TEP, formative or the equivalent number of teeth of pinion, is equal to 22.26. Now let us find the formative number of teeth of gear, TEG. So TEG is equal to TG sec theta p 2. So TG is equal to 60 sec theta p 2 is equal to 70.7. So 181.5. Formative number of teeth of gear TEG is equal to 181.5. Now let us find out the value of y dash p and y dash g. Okay, then we have to select which material is weaker. So for that, find the product of yp and sigma. Okay, then yg and sigma. So for that, let us find y dash p. So y dash p is equal to equation for that. For 14 and half degree composite system, the equation of y dash Lewis form factor is 0.124 minus 0.684 divided by TEP. Okay, so therefore 0.124 minus 0.684 upon TEP is equal to 22.26. So therefore y dash p is equal to 0.093. Now similarly find the y dash g. Okay, so y dash g, Lewis form factor for gear, 0.124 minus 0.684 divided by TEG. So 0.124 minus 0.684 upon TEG is equal to 181.5. So therefore y dash g is equal to 0.12. Now let us find the product of sigma op and y dash p. Okay, so the product of sigma op and y dash p, sigma op into y dash p. Sigma op is equal to 85 and y dash p is equal to 0.093 is equal to 7.905. Similarly, product of sigma og into y dash g, sigma og is equal to 55 megapascal and y dash g we have find 0.12, so is equal to 6.6. Now you can see here this sigma og into y dash g is less than sigma op into y dash p. So therefore we can say a design. Okay, so gear, material of the gear is weaker than material of the pinion. So our design should be based on the gear. Okay, so here we can say design should be based upon gear. Right. Now let us find the torque on the gear. So you know that the torque T is equal to P into 60 upon 2 pi ng. Okay, so our design is based upon gear. So therefore torque T is equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi ng. So is equal to P is equal to 9000 power into 60 divided by 2 pi, ng is equal to 420. So therefore 204.6 newton into meter. So therefore torque is equal to 204.600 newton into millimeter. Okay, value of torque. Now Let us find the tangential load WT. So tangential load WT is equal to T, torque upon radius. So radius is equal to dg by 2. So therefore 2T divided by dg is equal to m into tg. Okay. Now put value here. 2 into 2,04,600 divided by m into 60. Okay. So value of tangential load WT is equal to 6,820 by m Newton tangential load. Okay. Now let us find the pitch line velocity. Okay. So pitch line velocity V is equal to pi Tg Ng by 60. Okay. So therefore pi Tg is equal to m into Tg into Ng divided by 60. Now put the value in this equation. So V is equal to pi into m into 60 into 420 divided by 60. Okay. So therefore we can say 1320 mm per second. Okay. Mm per second. So now convert it into meter per second. So V is equal to 1.32 m meter per second. Now let us find the value of velocity factor. So velocity factor CV, you know that CV is equal to 6 upon 6 plus V, equation of velocity factor CV. So therefore 6 upon 6 plus 1.32 m. Okay. Now we know that the length of pitch cone element, that is the L. Okay. So L is given by equation L is equal to dg by 2 sin theta p2. Okay. And dg is equal to m into tg by 2 sin 70.7. Okay. So is equal to m into 60 divided by 2 into sin 70.7 is equal to 0.9438. So therefore, we can say pitch cone length L is equal to 32 m millimeter. Now let us assume the face width B is equal to 1/3 of length of pitch cone element. So right here, assume face width B is equal to L by 3. So L is equal to, we know that the 32 m by 3. So face width is equal to 10.67 m millimeter. Okay. Now put the Lewis equation, and you know that the Lewis equation for bevel gear WT is equal to sigma OG into CV. Our design is based on gear, so that's why we are using this sigma OG into B into pi into M into Y dash G. इनटू बीवेल फैक्टर, बीवेल फैक्टर इज इक्वल टू एल माइनस बी बाय एल. ओके नाउ पुट द वैल्यू इन दिस इक्वेशन. डब्ल्यू टी इज इक्वल टू वी हैव फाइंड 6820 बाय एम. ओके इज इक्वल टू सिग्मा ओ जी 55 एंड सी वी इज इक्वल टू 6 अपॉन 6 प्लस 1.32 एम इंटू बी इज इक्वल टू 10.67 एम इंटू पाई एम. वाई डैश जी इज इक्वल टू 0.12 इंटू बीवेल फैक्टर वैल्यू ऑफ एल. एल इज इक्वल टू 32 एम माइनस बी इज इक्वल टू 10.67 एम अपॉन 32 एम. ओके नाउ बाय सिंप्लीफाइंग दिस इक्वेशन. ओके आफ्टर द सिंप्लीफाइंग दिस इक्वेशन यू विल गेट 885 मीटर स्क्वेयर. ओके एम स्क्वेयर अपॉन 6.1.32 एम. ओके सो फाइनली यू विल गेट वन मोर इक्वेशन एंड दैट इक्वेशन इज 40920 प्लस 9002 एम इज इक्वल टू 885 एम स्क्वेर. ओके नाउ यू हैव टू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन बाय हीट एंड ट्रायल मेथड. सो आफ्टर सॉल्विंग दिस इक्वेशन बाय हीट एंड ट्रायल मेथड यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ मॉड्यूल. सो देयर फॉर मॉड्यूल एम इज इक्वल टू 4.52. ओके एंड 4.52 इज इक्वल टू वी कैन से 5 मिलीमीटर. तो मॉड्यूल एम इज इक्वल टू 5 मिलीमीटर. दिस इज अवर आंसर. ओके सो सिमिलरली यू कैन फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ बी. सो बी इज इक्वल टू 10.67 एम. सो देयर फॉर 10.67 इंटू 5 सो बी इज इक्वल टू 53.35. ओके से इज इक्वल टू 54 mm. So module is equal to 5 mm and face width B is equal to 54. Let us find out the gear diameter. Okay. So gear diameter DP DP is equal to M into TP. Okay. So is equal to 5 into 21. Is equal to 1. Now find the pitch circle diameter for the gear DG. So DG is equal to M into TG. Okay, so is equal to 5 into 60 is equal to 300 mm. Okay, now let us check for dynamic load. Check for dynamic load. Okay, so the velocity V is equal to 1.32 m is equal to 1.32 into 5 is equal to 6.6 meter per second. Okay, so tangential tooth load WT is equal to 6820 by m and is equal to 6820 by 5. So is equal to 1364 Newton. Okay, this is the tangential load. Now from the design data book we have to find out the gear tooth error. Okay, so considering the first class commercial gear having the module 5 mm, so from the design data book you can find the value of E. E is equal to 0.055 millimeter. Okay, value of tooth error action E. Okay, so corresponding value of K, taking the value of K, K is equal to 0.107, okay, for 14 and a half degree composite teeth, and EP, okay, modulus of elasticity of pinion for steel, 210 into 10^3 Newton per mm square. And similarly, value of EG is equal to for cast iron, it is 84 into 10^3 Newton per mm square. Okay. Now let us find the deformation or the dynamic factor C. So value of deformation or dynamic factor C is equal to, you know that, K into E divided by 1 upon EP plus 1 upon EG. So is equal to 0.107 into 0.055 divided by 1 upon 210 into 10^3 plus 1 upon 84 into 10^3. Okay, so therefore you will get the value of C is equal to 353 Newton per mm. Okay, now let us find the dynamic load. So dynamic load WD. Okay, dynamic load WD is equal to, we know that the WT plus incremental load, and that incremental load is equal to 21V into BC plus WT divided by 21V into, so 21V plus root BC plus WT dynamic load. Now put the value in this equation. So WT is equal to 1364 plus 21, V is equal to 6.6, B is equal to 54, C is equal to 353, plus again WT is equal to 1364 divided by 21V into V is equal to 6.6 plus root 54 into 353 plus 1364. Okay, so therefore from this equation you will find the dynamic load WD is equal to 11,418 Newton. Okay, WD is equal to 11,418 Newton. Now the BHN is given for the cast iron, BHN is equal to 160. So therefore, flexural endurance limit, we have to find from the design data book, the flexural endurance limit according to the 160 BHN. So the value of the flexural endurance limit sigma E is equal to 84 Newton per mm square. Okay. So therefore, let us find the static load WS. WS is equal to sigma E into B into pi into M into Y dash G. Okay. Now put the value in this equation. So 84 into 54 into pi, M is equal to 5 and 0.12. So therefore, the steady load or the static load is equal to 8,552 Newton. Okay. So here you can see this static load, okay, is less than dynamic load. So therefore our design is not satisfactory. Okay. So design is not satisfactory in terms of the static load. So we have already discussed that in spur gear, that WS, it should be greater than or equal to 1.25 WD for steady load. So So for the satisfactory design against the dynamic load, let us take the precision gear having tooth error in action E is equal to 0.015 mm for a module of 5 mm. Okay, so for that, let us take the value E. E is equal to 0.015. Okay, change the value for the precision gear. E is equal to 0. Now find again the dynamic factor C. So dynamic factor C, C is equal to 0.107 into 0.015 divided by 1 upon 210 into 10 raised to 3 plus 1 upon 84 into 10 raised to 3. So dynamic factor is 96 Newton per mm. Okay, now again find the dynamic load. So WD, the dynamic load WD is equal to 1364 plus here 21 into 6.6, then B is equal to 54 and C is equal to 96 plus 1364, okay, divided by 21 into 6.6 plus root 54 into 96 plus 1364. Okay, so you will get the dynamic load 5498 Newton. Okay, by considering the precision gear and by changing the value of tooth error action. Okay, now you can say the WS static load is greater than dynamic load. Okay, so here WS is greater than WD. Now our design is safe in static load condition. Now we have to check for the wear load. Okay, so write down here, check for wear load. Okay, so for the wear load, we know that the BHN, renal hardness number, is equal to 160 for cast iron gear. So for that, the surface endurance limit sigma ES, surface endurance limit sigma ES is equal to 630 Newton per mm square. Okay, now load stress factor, well, find the value of load stress factor K. K is equal to sigma ES square into sin phi divided by 1.4 into 1 upon EP plus 1 upon EG. Okay, so therefore again put the value in this equation, 630 square sin 14.5 upon 1.4 by 1 upon EP is equal to 210 into 10 raised to 3 plus EG is equal to 84 into 10 raised to 3. So therefore, value of K is equal to 1.18 Newton per mm square. Okay, now let us find the ratio factor Q. So ratio factor Q, Q is equal to 2 into TEG by TEG plus TEP. So is equal to 2 into 181.5 divided by 181.5 plus 22.26, okay, is equal to 1.78. Now equation for the wear load WW is equal to DP into B into Q into A. So DP is 105 into 54 into 1.78 into 1.18. Okay, so therefore wear load is equal to 11,000
910 न्यूटन. तो फ्रॉम दैट वी कैन से दिस रियल लोड WW इज ग्रेटर देन द डायनेमिक लोड हियर, डायनेमिक लोड. देयरफॉर वी कैन से डिजाइन इज सेटिस्फैक्टरी. Okay, so by this way, you can solve the examples of bevel gear. Thank you very much.